Somehow we've made it all the way to episode 6. You know what's up.
Yes. Making camp here. Orders. Victory in your name, my lord. We have. We shall. As you wish.
Yes, my lord.
Ah, crud. There we go. Famous last words, but this should be easy. If they come out to fight us, good, but charging in a settlement is just too much trouble. They do have a little bit of an army in here, but it looks like they've already had some trouble.
This tower will keep. Yes.
Alrighty, Oogluk, let's do this, just you and me, and my bodyguards.
Muster your. Our men have slain the enemy general.
Well, ain't that a shame. You have a mission for me? It looks like Ishthrak is the new faction leader. They seem to go through those pretty quickly these days. Let's get another diplomat. Oh no. Well, we might be fine, or we might not. This will be the first fight in the campaign where we get to use our farmhand pikemen. We're finally gonna see how failsome these guys are. Oh boy. What do you think you're doing? These farmhand pikemen can go toe-to-toe with elite enemies. They will lose most of their number, but the grind will be slow enough that you can get around and flank them, or that your archers can get off all their shots. They are by no means the best pikemen in the game, as anyone who plays this mod can tell you, but they will serve their purpose. Oh, wow. We actually captured their leader there. I doubt they'll be able to pay the ransom, but I still think we should try. Oh my god. Well, that was a fun campaign. Wow, granted, they only have 2 detachments of pikemen, but I think this is too many even for Eomer to take.
We are disgraced.
Oh. Nice. Look at that treasury. Holy crap. We have another diplomat. Let's send him north. We have a full stack army, as well as 2 smaller ones standing right nearby. Exactly what to do about that, I'm not entirely certain. Would you like some trade rights? There might be a little honor in it.
You would speak of something more?
Hey, your wealth is modest. Would you perhaps like to buy some map information for 1,000 gold?
Very well. There is merit in your suggestion.
Thanks, I thought so.
Vigilant.
there is one thing I think we can do, and that is we can go around the full stack and attack this guy over here. If we attacked this guy, both the other armies would reinforce. But if we attack this guy, only this smaller army will reinforce. At least that's the idea.
Yes, my lord.
That looks practically manageable. Well, sometimes the last six orcs do in fact get away. So we still have a full stack army on our doorstep.
I'm gonna stick you.
But now they stand alone. Isenrun is not looking safe right now, but if I put Eomer in there, that won't make them any less likely to attack, it will just make it more likely that Eomer will die defending it. I doubt they'll wait four turns to besiege us, but if they do, it'll be worth it. Maybe if we send Eomer westward, Shogflok will try to follow him. It's risky, but it could work.
We shall engage.
And if it doesn't, then he's right here. There goes that turn. And just like that, we are going to lose Sigurd. He had a good run. Not really much point in bothering. We have overextended ourselves. Are you sure he's game for it after what happened to the last guy? No. A military unit. Well, that is timely. We can't really besiege it, and it threatens all the rest of our expansion down here to Derwath and Gind. On the other hand, they are not very likely to leave Isenrun ungarrisoned or lightly garrisoned. I have a sneaky suspicion that if we fight their other armies, they will split this force. And if the forces split, then we'll be able to handle it piecemeal. We absolutely can take out these two armies, and I think we should. It's gonna be a little bit complicated, but we can do it.
Continue like this, we will smash the enemy. Behold how our cowardly foe runs. It's time to let all who remember this day remember it as the day of our most glorious victory.
What?
Cool. Oops.
That was weird. Oh my, wow. That does not feel fair. This entire stack just disappeared out of Isenrun, and then they paid their ransom for the archers. That was weird. Ah, man. Well, folks, there you have it. That's how you beat Isengard.
Symbol, you just get up and change the channel.
Release the river!
I wasn't joking.
No.
Any chance we could change it back?
What will become of the forces of the White Hand remains a mystery. No, it doesn't. We're gonna siege them anyway. Saruman's dreams are troubled of late. I should think so. He's been dead for a couple of turns now. That is disappointing. We do still need to take Isengard, and Dunland is probably going to come in and attack us at some point. That's okay. They can try. We're gonna wanna clean up these rebel armies, and with our primary threat out of the way, we can start to really build Rohan up. Life has proven to be miserable, disappointing, and short. Unless, of course, you're Saruman, but even in his case, it's still over. That said, we will still see you in the next one.